is turning. Gonna like that, ain't you, baby?
Side to side, up and down, back and forward.
And Burrito's gonna enjoy it, isn't she?
Yeah.
She's enjoyed everything so far, bless her.
Apart from me kicking her ass.
Don't kick donkey. Okay. So, this is a bit of the lovely twisty turny.
Nice trees, we've got the mountains, the Pyrenees, here we come.
So funny, because we've driven this so many times, haven't we?
Yeah. Ooh, and even in the car you feel like you're going to tip over.
Yeah.
Oh,
so we've driven this in a Jag,
in a
Lexus hybrid, we've driven it in a TT.
That was fun.
That was big fun.
That was real fun.
That was one of the times when it was one of our first holiday without kids, weren't it? So yeah. It was like getting old and rebellious and reckless.
It was like a go-kart around these tracks.
Oh, look at this.
That's stunning.
This is what we love about driving.
Yeah, cast today. It's not as sad as it
yeah,
was.
Yeah, no, that's okay though. The filming is okay.
Yeah.
But, yeah, just breathtaking.
Look at that.
It's never the same on film as when you experience it firsthand, but we thought we'd let you see what we're experiencing. It also helps you to forget all the things that went wrong yesterday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Another day, take two.
Yeah, take two. We're positive, people, we're positive. Right, okay, I'll show you any more pretty things that we see along the way. See you later. Again, just look at this.
Excuse the background noise.
We'll put music over this, I think.
Flat.
We'll just do the big roll.
Oh, okay.
I just want them to see the view.
See the peaks of it. just
it is so impressive. So I'm going to leave it on there, because that's how it's.
It's impressive.
It's just amazing.
It's 1,000 meters above ground level.
And it was an English architect, wasn't it?
Yeah.
That it designed
French, it. English architect.
Yeah.
As Clarkson would say.
So. And here we go. I want to look.
Behind this bridge, or viaduct, whatever you want to call it, is that everyone used to drive through the town of Meaux, and it used to get congested and everything else, and all the locals got fed up with all the congestion during the summer months and everything else. So they built this so that people could get past their town or whatever. So now people go to the town to take photos of the viaduct.
The viaduct.
So it's still exactly the same, you've still got the same congestion problems. But yeah, so that was the story of the viaduct. That was an interesting fact.
We're informative.
We don't do facts, but we do now.
But we've been across this viaduct a few times in a car. First time in a motorhome. We're doing lots of firsts this trip, aren't we?
First time smashing the wheel.
Let's not talk about it, let's not dwell on the past.
Dwell on the past.
Right, okay, so see you later. Welcome back. And look at our view now. Yes, we are on the Alta Pista de la Mediterranean. With a Spanish accent, that sounds even nicer. So yeah, so we are... What's that?
Well, you're sitting on my arse, mate.
Gonna go
what car
on
then? I
can't see. That's a fucking imitation. F*** at us like that, you
c***. Sitting on my f***ing arse. That's why. Instead of f***ing going past us. Dickhead.
We're nearly at our stop for the evening before we get to our final destination tomorrow. So I just thought I'd let you see our way into the campsite. It's stunning. Very much what I call rural, well, agricultural Spain, okay?
It's all olive trees and vineyards back there, weren't there?
Yeah.
Couldn't get a camera in time, sorry.
Yeah, right, so I'm gonna turn you around and let you have a look at this and play some nice Spanish music for you.
Oh yeah.
Don't spoil it.
All right, I'll start playing nice Spanish music now.
Hola,
no, you're singing.
No,
I'm going to put Spanish music. I won't.
No, put it into... over the top of that.
No. I'm going to start music now.
Let's hope so.
Turn left onto Carabao Alberto Tapia's Lumos, then take the first right.
Right, I see you, ready?
Yeah, so first left.
I can't get around it. Come on.
Now I'm frightened.
Yeah, okay.
Turn right onto Zedvada.
There's another way in the mission, I don't get that. This is like the f***ing dirt track that I was telling you about. Well, where is it now?
Here I'm going. 1.1 miles. That was. I'm glad I filmed that.
That can't be right.
Excuse my French. Oh, my hand hurts while I was gripping the camera so tight.
Yeah.
I've gone quite slowly because I think we're going to be here very soon.
In 3/4 of a mile, arrive at Camping Restaurant Park on the left.
On the left. You'll notice it. It stands out quite a bit.
This must be it here.
I think it's like a dirt track. Well, it's not a dirt track.
Oh, that was the local football club.
Yeah. Oh, that was interesting getting through them towns.
Oh,
a bit tight.
Excuse my leg. You're going to have to put music all over that because I'm swearing like a
trooper.
Yeah.
Yeah, you get in the reception. Well, no, because it doesn't say thingy, does it? Are you still filming?
Yeah.
Oh, she's still filming. Sorry. Bye.
Good morning. And we are on our final leg of the journey. It's day 3 of travelling. We are in Maserat Park. I asked the lady when we got here, who was lovely, really helpful. She basically, when I said, we're YouTubers, do you mind us filming? Which I always do because, you know, I don't want to offend anyone. This is a hobby for us. This is just us recording memories and our journey of gradually becoming full-time motorhomers. And she said, if you don't mind filming, don't film, because this park is just been bought out and the residents are not happy. And we don't want to upset anyone. This is their home. You know, we're coming here for one night, actually. So we're respecting that. So I'm only going to just show you the size of the pitch because it's massive. This is a place that I think, since it's been taken over, has not been maintained. You can tell, I'm a gardener, and you can tell by it's not being clipped, it's not being trained, the weeds, etc. But, oh my God, this is a lovely park. So as long as you can see beyond that it's in a transition stage between what it was and what it's about to become, which we read online last night just to see what it was all about, it's going to go as an only camp. We've only done one only camp and we weren't impressed, but that's just us. And it was one camp. Could go to another one and it's amazing. So it's not fair. It's a bit like when you've got branded global products, certain ones are going to be good and certain ones are going to be bad. But this morning, I'm just going to literally show you the size of this, and I hope you, like me, can see that this is a beautiful spot and that it's got so much potential, and I really hope Only Camp take it over and do justice to it, because it's such a lovely spot. I mean, as we were driving here, we were just like, oh, this is beautiful. You know, it's really, really lovely. So I'm going to take you outside. So this is our view this morning. Must learn the name of these trees that stretch out and meet the other tree, and you train them to join together, and it gives that natural barrier and shade in Spain that is so needed. But there, that's the size of the pitch. You know, it's fully serviced, although we can't see waste. But yeah, so this is it. Child blocks just over there. As I say, I'm not going to go far because I'm respecting the fact they don't want us to film, just because there's some very upset, disgruntled people. Water, electric, okay, shower block, and again, that's your site. Look at the size of these spots. It's just amazing. Poor burrito, so dirty. Look at that little damaged bit. Thanks, JP, that message. You know, it done the world for Kevin. It is a motorhoming thing. It does happen occasionally. We were being rushed. We had people sort of like nigh on bibbing behind us, like to get onto this pitch. And then when I looked at the map and walked around, I realised it was the smallest pitch on there. And yet there was other people that had tents that literally had the size of this. And it's like, well, if you show people to a pitch because you can work out what size the vehicle is, then doesn't that make sense? Perhaps I'm being far too sensible and pragmatic, but that is the consequence. We're never going to be rushed again. Do you know what? We wait for people, and if people don't like it, then that's on them, that's not on us. I think we're so accommodating that sometimes people take the mickey out of us, and we're not going to have that happen again, because that's I have no clue what that's going to cost, but it was a costly mistake. Bikes have made it, but look at this size of the pitch. Just look at it. Massive. Residential, residential, and then you've got your pitches. But wow, look at that. Amazing. Okay. And I'm going to end this little bit here because I'm going to pack up and we're on our last leg. And then we can set up properly for 2 weeks on a 5-star campsite, which we will review and let you know. Is it worth it? Is it worth the hype? Compared to some sites that we've paid similar money to per night. I'm hoping that it's a lot better than what we've experienced the last 2 days, okay? But we've slept really well last night, and that always makes the day brighter, okay? Anyway, take care. See you soon.